Welcome, Collective Hustle family. Today we have Jennifer Redondo Marquez and Rose Buado, co-authors and co-founders of In Her Purpose, the book and the lifestyle brand. Welcome, you guys.
Thank you.
So we have a one-year anniversary that we're celebrating. So it's actually been officially 1 year since you have launched In Her Purpose, both the book and the platform, right?
Yes. Yes, we're so excited about it.
For full disclosure, I have been very honored to be a part of it. I have, you know, little couple pages within the book, and I've been, you know, just so honored to be able to not only participate, but also, you know, witness and be a part of this journey, because the last year has been one of evolution in more ways than one. But since then, you guys have created quite the lifestyle brand out of In Her Purpose, because not only is it a book, but it's a couple other things now. Do you want to tell me about that a little bit?
Yeah. So, I mean, I thought I was just signing up to write a book. That was the goal. And then it turned out to be so much more. You know, once the book came out, a ton of people, women and men, all colors, all ages, reached out to both Rose and I for help, whether that's on how to start a business or help on building their resume or interviewing. So we ended up building coaching classes and virtual events because we were at home, staying at home. And so we really had to adapt to that. And on top of that, we also started an e-commerce store, not just to sell our book, but also to support local businesses and people within our community on a platform for extra marketing for them.
So let me get this straight. You guys are doing life and business coaching on top of, you know, managing an online store, on top of really doing outreach that, you know, and, you know, book tours, and not book tours, obviously, because we couldn't really do any tours, but everything that is entailed. Yeah.
We'd like to.
And on top of that, we're also doing events. So we're doing all of these great collaborations and partnerships with other, especially with other women in our book, where we're throwing events for them and for us, and then making it more of a charitable contribution to different communities.
Yes, congratulations again on your latest event, Rise and Thrive, which we were also so happy to be a part of. So congratulations. It was a huge success.
Thank you.
Well, without the being,
Well, there was also one more thing that we forgot to talk about. Rose and I also do consulting services. Like, a ton of people have asked us to help them solve problems or help them with projects that they've always wanted to kick off but don't know how to. Mm-hmm. So we recently started to take on more of that as well.
Wow. You guys didn't know that the pandemic year was going to be your busiest.
No.
it's a bittersweet, right?
Well, with that being said, you know, I'd really like to talk about, you know, I'm sure you guys learned so much, you know, now it's a full-fledged business, you know, it has legs of its own. It's become, you know, larger than life. But with that being said, I'm sure, you know, you guys, if you had to do it all over again, maybe you guys had maybe a couple tips that, or things that you would have done differently, or, you know, how can we, you know, what kind of advice would you give to our community who is interested in following in your footsteps and thinking, hey, I want to self-publish a book also, you know, what would you do differently, or what kind of advice would you give to them? I know there's a lot, but let's start with a couple.
Oh my gosh, there's so many. But the first thing for sure is just know that you can, right? Know that you can do it. Know that, I mean, there's so many. I actually, if I think back to it, I don't think I would have chosen to do something differently, because I loved how everything turned out. There were times where we had that moment where, like, oh, we're too busy to get to it, but we ended up, you know, like rolling up our sleeves and actually just starting to focus. I mean, there was one time where I went out to Jen to the up north, and the whole day we just worked on it, right? Like, I thought that was like such a good time. I think I don't think I would have changed that. That was such a great experience for both of us. That was like the day that we decided to, like, okay, let's just get it done. We had already finished interviewing everybody, and we're like, now what? But for sure, the first one is just know that you can. You can do this. You can write a book. It sounds so like far-fetched, right? Thinking like, oh, I'm gonna write a book and I'm gonna publish it and make it happen. But just know that you can. You can definitely do that. That would be my first one.
Jen. The second would be, even though you don't know how to do something, you can figure it out. And what I mean by that is there's a ton of resources available. Google, there's a ton of groups online on Facebook. Basically, any of those groups you can join, and most people that there's someone that's done whatever you want to do. So whether it's writing a book or learning how to cook something, you can go on to YouTube. So we certainly learned a lot from Google and Facebook, also on YouTube. So don't be afraid to reach out to people. Most people are super helpful because they've done it before and they've been in your shoes.
Did we do that? Did we reach out to other people? I feel like we
Yeah.
did a lot of research, right?
We did we did a lot of research, but some things where we couldn't find information on, we started going on to like the Ingram Spark groups, like especially so when it starts to get super technical, that's when we're like, okay, we need someone who's written or self-published a book. And
So you got a lot of help from the community, and you just were like, you know what? We don't know this, but we're gonna find out.
And then even afterwards, sometimes Rose and I would be on there, we're like, okay, we know the answers to these questions. So we would also respond back just because we didn't want to just be takers. So now that we knew the answers to it, we started to field the questions that we knew the answers to.
So what came as a surprise? What are things that, if I want to write a book and I don't know anything about anything about anything about self-publishing, where do I start? What was one thing that I need to, I should, be concerned about because, you hit that roadblock?
I think one thing that I was probably most surprised about, oh my gosh, I'm just trying to think back because it's been like 2 years, right, that we did this process. One thing that I was most surprised about would probably have to be the team that we had to put together to make it happen. So Jen and I did a lot of gathering the people that we wanted to write in the book. But there's more than just that. Like, you have to have an artist for the illustration. You have to have an editor because you want to make sure there's no typos in that book, right? And then on top of that, you have to have wait, the
A
illustration,
formatter, a
editor, the
formatter.
formatter. Oh my goodness. You have every book size has this particular format for every store, for every online store. Like, if it's an ebook, it needs to be a different size. If it's on Amazon, it needs to be a different size. So there's just all of that, and you need to have the right people on your team for sure. Or you just have to research really well and know how to look up definitions for each word that is like a tech word. We are not tech people at all, but we did it. So I
No,
think
but
that,
we are tech people. This was just different, right? It was.
you are right. You are right.
Then the other thing that came to surprise, and I kept telling Rose, like, no, we're gonna need more time. And the reason why I knew we were gonna need more time is because when you print out a book, it might not come out the way you imagined it, right? And sure enough, when we got our first book, the border was off. Some of the flowers were bleeding onto our binding, and I was like, that's not the style. That's not how it's supposed to look. And so we had to reprint a few times and reformat so that it was perfect.
And also, I think another thing that we we need to think about, like, when you're going to write, is you have to be very organized. Make sure you know what files belong to what, if it's a revision one or a revision two of everything, the artwork, the editing, and all of that stuff. So if you're like a project manager, you got this. You're going to be fine.
No, that's awesome. So what's next for you guys? Is there a
so
sequel? Is there
things.
Another book? Is there an empire? What's next?
Well, for sure, I would like to be able to grow our coaching programs, to be able to be more resourceful to our community, and then to be able to grow the community. That's something that I envision, and I would hope that everything will pan out that way. That's one of the first things, but there's so many more, right, Jen? There's our events that we do for, you know, charitable causes. I know Jen and I have talked about writing a second book, so we've been thinking about that too, but because of all of the current situation with with what's happening in the world, we're like, well, let's just hold off on that until things go back to normal so that we can go out there and start like talking to more people and just growing that part of the book. So we definitely want to do that. But I know Jen has so much more and we are so open to doing everything.
Yeah, I actually, Oni, you're the one who introduced me to Create and Cultivate. And I remember going to a few of their events here in San Francisco and I thought, wow, this is amazing. This is super neat. Like I want to do something like this. I want to build something like this. And I really, I see us building something like that for people of color and not just color, all colors basically. And not just for women, men too. Like they started to feel a little FOMO from our first event in real life. And so we invited them to the last one, which was pretty cool. Like they all had a really great time. And so, you know, we started out as a woman brand and they always laugh when it's like, I'm going to make something called In His Purpose or whatever. So, our brand is In Her Purpose, but we've pretty much opened it up to anyone and everyone.
Yes.
And what else?
We also want to keep consulting, right? I think we're having a good time being able to help other businesses scale and what they're doing. I love, you know, the whole marketing part of business. So being able to share knowledge and learn more about that and being able to contribute to other businesses is something that I think we're pretty passionate about. Jen's really good at it too. So, so I think that's something that we're doing. But yeah, there's just so many. We just, I'm excited about it. We have a very long journey and I cannot wait how things are going to turn out.
Well, we're excited to, you know.
Jen, our Uber.
Oh yeah, I was just going to say. So, I mean, there's a few other things that we did not talk about. So during the pandemic, we ended up making our own ube extract. So kind of like, I want ube extract to be like in the grocery store, like vanilla extract, like right there at Whole Foods, at Trader Joe's. I mean, you know, they have ube everything and that thing sells out like crazy. Like I want to do that with ube extract. I want that to be a staple in people's homes. What else? Oh, the other thing that I want, like I talk about this all the time and I have no idea how this is going to happen, but like, I kind of want to make like a documentary or like TV series kind of on Netflix. I've seen a lot of series. Well, because you're home, you're just watching TV all the time and you're like, I can make a documentary about that. I can make a show about women or entrepreneurs and things like that. So that's another thing that I think about.
Yeah. And I love that idea. So there's so many things that we have planned and we're Jen and I, like you put us together, we are doers. So like we, when we decide on something, we like actually make it happen. So I'm really proud about that for us. And I think that has a lot to do with Jen. She's very, very on thing. So yeah, it's funny because everything we say eventually happens. So we're just gonna keep saying it. We're gonna have a documentary out there.
Well, that leads me to my next question. So I'm sure throughout a year and a half of just kind of, putting your heads down and getting through it, I'm sure you guys hit a couple, slumps where you're just, as far as motivation, as far as, maybe there's a roadblock because you can't figure out, the right direction one way or another, or maybe you butt heads on something. What do you do when you, what did you guys do to kind of get over that roadblock?
I mean, luckily we're very different and we are good at different things. So like the things I hate to do, she loves to do, and vice versa. So we never argue about that because we like to do different things. So we
Yeah.
don't.
So find a partner that.
Yeah. I think that that's important. If you're gonna do this with anybody, being able to have different abilities, like skill sets, is very important. And then also the whole thing of if one person isn't motivated, the other person has to be the motivator. And it switches all the time. So sometimes Jen is like my cheerleader, right? She'll be like, no, you can do this. Just, make it happen. And then I'll get that burst of energy to make it happen. And then sometimes when she's down, I'm like, okay, no, you got this. Let's figure out what it is that we need to do, and then let's just make it happen. So it's very like in any relationship, right? If a person's mad, you guys can't be both mad. Like there has to be a balance there. So we have a very good balance.
And more so for me, I don't want to let Rose down and tell her, oh, you know what, I didn't do that. There's some days where I'm like, look, I just didn't have time to do that. And it gets pushed to the side. I mean, there's only two of us and there's only so many hours in the day. But I mean, she's a mom and she has multiple businesses and she's a wife. So I have no idea how she does it. So when I say I didn't do something, I kind of feel like, oh my God, what's my excuse? What's my reason?
No, oh my God, Jen can never, never, ever put me down. We are fine. We're good.
Guys have an awesome partnership, and there's a lot of like, and you guys, there's a lot of symbiotic nature, but then also, you feel accountable to each other, and I think that's important in any partnership, marriage or business, so.
Yeah. We hold each other very much accountable, so.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys. It was so great to chat with you. Is there any, do you have any kind of like last, words of advice for our budding publishers or our budding authors?
Yeah, I mean, if you have something in your mind, if you have something in your heart that you feel that you need to share with the world, and you feel like it's writing a book, or even if it's sharing the idea or opening or starting a new business, you need to go for it. Like the only person that's stopping you to making that happen is yourself. So I think like if it's in your heart, it's in your mind. Don't wait any longer. Just make it happen. Take the first step. Start asking the right questions and commit to it. So, and you can do it. You can totally do it. If Jen and I have never written a book before in our life, and then, a year ago it hit number one bestseller on Amazon, there is no way that other people cannot do it. It is an amazing journey. And if it's in your heart, it's in your mind, make it happen. Do it.
Jen?
Wow, she said pretty much everything. I mean, I'm just super happy that there are more creators and business people in our community, and to be in the mainstream, like our book got picked up at Target.com. So that's like huge, right? For us to be in a mainstream, huge American business. Like for me, that's like we're doing things, we're on the right path. So even though like a dream might seem super far away, just know that it's possible. It doesn't happen overnight. It's just a lot of work and discipline.
Awesome. Thank you guys for joining us. Happy 1 year anniversary, and we look forward to, catching up and having you on your second anniversary where you guys have multiplied everything we talked about times 10. So,
Oh my
thank you.
gosh.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Bye.